Welcome to Holman United Methodist Church, located in Los Angeles, California. We are a church that believes in the Word of God as it is manifested in Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. We believe in the Holy Bible, and we trust that there is a word of hope, instruction, and healing for us all. Thanks for joining us today, and let's journey together as we follow God.
Welcome to the Holman United Methodist Church, the Church of the Bells. We are located at 3320 West Adams Boulevard in the historic West Adams District of Los Angeles. The Reverend Dr. Ken Walden serves as our senior pastor. We are pleased to be worshiping in person in our sanctuary once again. If you'd like to join with us next week or subsequent weeks, please go to holmanchurch.com to register, or just come on down on Sunday mornings either at 8 or 11 and you can register in person on site. And good morning again. Welcome to the Church of the Bells. It's the third Sunday of Advent, December 12th, 2021. Today's broadcast ministry is sponsored in tribute to the Amen Incorporated International STEM Center and its founders, Professor Hildreth Hal Walker and Dr. Betty Davis Walker. Dr. Walker conducted this first pilot education research project focusing on science and funded by UCLA in 1986. More than tens of thousands of youth have completed the STEM program and graduated from colleges and universities worldwide. To God be the glory, and we thank Hal and Betty for their support. We encourage you to visit and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Type youtube.com/Holman Church in your internet browser, or you can go to YouTube directly and type Holman Church in the search box. There you will see worship services and other engaging content. We ask you to click the thumbs up button, subscribe, and then click the bell icon to receive notifications. And again, please subscribe. During these unprecedented times, we encourage you to stay safe, but also remember that churches around the world, as well as Holman, are still in need of your financial support and prayers. So we offer them for you and hope that you have a safe and blessed week. This ministry is broadcast live on radio station KJLH 102.3 in the greater Los Angeles area. You can also view it on the Holman Church YouTube channel everywhere. This provides broad outreach opportunities to the listening and viewing audience. We are grateful for this opportunity to be in ministry with the greater community through the generosity of our radio broadcast sponsors. We look forward to your support through your radio broadcast sponsorship to honor a loved one, celebrate a special occasion, or promote your business or event. Call Holman Church at 323-703-5868 for more information. You can also contribute online to our ministry or other activities at holmanchurch.com. Let us partner with you in sharing your news. Thank you for listening, and we now join the church service currently in progress.
Welcome. Welcome to the Holman United Methodist Church worship experience. I am so glad to see each and every one of you. And I'm also happy for those of you who may be listening to us on the radio and joining us also on social media. This is the third Sunday of Advent, for we light the candle of joy. Many of us know that in the very first book of the Bible, the book that we call Genesis, the first chapter, the third verse, the very first words that our God conveyed across the universe, God said, "Let there be light." And I am so glad that our God did not want us to exist and move in darkness. I am so glad that during the season of Advent, that we as people of faith, we light the candle. We continue to light the candle and let there be light and in the world. I am so glad that our brothers and sisters in Judaism, they too light candles during Hanukkah. And I am also glad that in a few days, in a few weeks, we will be lighting candles during Kwanzaa. It is during this season of Advent we are reminded the importance of light. God said, "Let there be light." As people of God, we are called to follow the light of hope, the light of love, the light of joy. And as people of God, we are called to worship.
Please join me in our lighting of the Advent candle. We come to worship you this day, O God, this third Sunday of Advent. We have lit the first two candles, one for hope and one for love. Today we light the third candle, the candle of joy. It is our joy in knowing that God's absolute presence is in our lives. Rejoice in God always, and I say rejoice, for God has created you with the capacity for joy. We find what makes us joyful and make that our gift to the world. Watch and wait for Christ's coming. Remember the promises of God with prayer. All is ready. Let the light of these candles called hope, love, and joy bring brightness to our spirits as we hope for your arrival, O Lord. As we receive your love that leads the way, as we wait and watch and wonder how you might reveal yourself to us, God, give us joy in your advent. Fill us the kind of joy that cannot be contained, but must be shared. May we walk in the light of Christ. Amen. Let us join in worship as we sing our opening hymn, O Come, Emmanuel, number 211 in our hymnal.
Captive in
join me in our invocation. Let us pray. Lord, we have come to this place from a world of demands and schedules. We have sought hope and love and have found them here. Now we seek the inner joy that only your presence can bring to our lives. Open our hearts and our spirits as we worship you, that your unspeakable joy will be revealed. For this we ask in Jesus' name, amen. We will now receive the ministry of music, but who may abide the day of his coming? Soloist Kenneth Scott.
Who shall stand when he appeareth?
Our scripture this morning is found in the New Testament, the Gospel of Luke, chapter 3, verses 7 through 18. Please rise as you are able for the reading of the gospel. I invite you to listen and follow along as I read the scripture. John said to the crowds that came out to be baptized by him, "You brood of vipers, who warned you to flee from the wrath to come? Bear fruits worthy of repentance. Do not begin to say to yourselves, 'We have Abraham as our ancestor.' For I tell you, God is able from these stones to raise up children to Abraham. Even now, the axe is lying at the root of the trees. Every tree, therefore, that does not bear good fruit is cut down and thrown into the fire." And the crowds asked him, When then should we do? What then shall we do?" In reply, he said to them, "Whoever has two coats must share with anyone who has none, and whoever has food must do likewise." Even tax collectors came to be baptized, and they asked him, "Teacher, what should we do?" He said to them, "Collect no more than the amount prescribed for you." Soldiers also asked him, "And we, what should we do?" He said to them, "Do not extort money from anyone by threats or false accusations, and be satisfied with your wages." And the people were filled with expectation, and all were questioning in their heart concerning John, whether he might be the Messiah. John answered all of them by saying, "I baptize you with water, but the one who is more powerful than I is coming. I'm not worthy to untie the thong of his sandals. He will baptize you with the Holy Spirit and fire. His winnowing fork is in his hand to clear his threshing floor and to gather the wheat into his granary. But the chaff he will burn with unquenchable fire." So with many exhortations, he explained the good news to the people. The word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God. Let us now receive the ministry of music by the Holman Vocal Quartet. Oh, you may be seated. The ministry of music by the Holman Vocal Quartet, "Lord, Be Pleased with My Praise," after which Reverend Dr. Ken J. Walden will bring the message for today. What should we do?
Lord, just be pleased with my praise.
According to the Gospel of Luke, the third chapter, you and I are faced with a question that continues to pop up again and again and again in this scripture text that we have, the Gospel of Luke, the third chapter, the 10th verse. And this question that continues to pop up again and again and again is the theme of the sermon today. And that question is, what should we do? What should we do? According to the Gospel of Luke, we find John the Baptist preaching a powerful sermon. And many of you know that John the Baptist was the cousin of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Some of you know that John the Baptist's mother was a person by the name of Elizabeth. And the scripture informs us that when Elizabeth was pregnant with John the Baptist, Mary was pregnant with Jesus. Some of you know that when the two ladies, when they were pregnant, they actually interacted with one another. And the Bible informs us that when Mary was pregnant with Jesus, Elizabeth was pregnant with John, when they saw one another, the two babies leaped, meaning that Jesus and John, they interacted with one another even in their mother's womb, striking similarities between John the Baptist and Jesus. Jesus refused to quit preaching and teaching about the goodness and mercy of God. So much so that Jesus oftentimes found himself in trouble with the law. Same thing with John the Baptist. John the Baptist refused to stop preaching and teaching about the goodness and mercy of God. So much so that John the Baptist also became in trouble with the law. What awesome commitment and unbelievable dedication John the Baptist had. John the Baptist had disciples. He commanded, accumulated people from near and far coming to hear him preach about the good news, about God's love, about God's mercy, about God's miraculous presence in the world. So much so that people started accumulating and following John the Baptist, according to the Gospel of Luke, the third chapter. Starting at the 10th verse, we find the question, the crowd asking, what should we do? What should we do? In response to God's love, in response to God's power, in response to God's grace, what should we do? And I believe that even in 2021, there's a crowd here at home in United Methodist Church asking the same question, what should we do? Even in 2021, across the radio waves, people are thinking and wanting to ask the question, what should we do? In 2021, even across social media, people are hearing about God's goodness, hearing and looking at God's grace, and we are asking the question, what should we do? A fascinating thing about John the Baptist, each and every time he heard the question, he gave a response. To the crowd, John the Baptist informs us that if you have one shirt or two shirts, give one. If you have some food to share, share the food. My brothers and sisters, in 2021, all of us should comprehend the fact that what's a little bit to others will be a lot to some. What's a little bit to others will be a lot to some. On this day, December 12th, 2021. Our hearts and our prayers also go out to our brothers and sisters in Kentucky and in the state of Illinois, because we are very aware of the fact that vicious tornadoes have ravaged some geographical areas. The information we are receiving, at least 70 people have died. At least, and they are still taking numbers. I want you to know that a phrase goes that the tables in life often turn, and they generally turn quickly. Less than 24 or 48 hours ago, there were people who owned homes, and the tables turned in the form of a tornado, and now they've become homeless. Less than 72 hours ago, people had loved ones in forms of brothers and sisters and mothers, aunts and uncles and nieces and nephews. In less than 72 hours, the tables had turned in the form of tornadoes, and now they've lost those loved ones, and may their spirits and souls rest in peace. Less than 72 hours ago, people had businesses and jobs they could go to, and the tables turned so quickly, many of those businesses have disappeared, literally. Looked like a bomb had dropped. John the Baptist gives us an important message that what should we do in 2021? Share. What should we do in 2021? Share food, share clothes. What may appear like a little bit to some will be a lot to others. That is why during this season of Advent, we light candles. We are reminded that as people of faith, we ought to receive the light of hope, receive the light of love, receive the light of joy. But we also have to remember our job is not only to receive the light, but also be the light of love, be the light of hope, be the light of joy. It's amazing that one of the things that John did not do was tell the people, what should you do? Do not do anything. Do not do anything. The enemy would like you to remain silent. The enemy would like you to remain still. The enemy would prefer you not to receive the light nor be the light. But John the Baptist reminds us that all of us, we have a responsibility. But the crowd wasn't the only ones that asked John. The crowd wasn't the only ones that asked John a question. There were others amongst John who belonged to a certain demographic. And we know that in verse 12, one of the groups of people that asked John what should they do, tax collectors. Now, the tax collectors, that is fascinating because the tax collectors, they were known as a group of people to take advantage of their constituents. The tax collectors, they were known as a group of people that always took more than was required. The tax collectors could be known as what we refer to today as the IRS. The tax collectors during the biblical times, they were not a group of people that conveyed joy. How many of you look forward to receiving a call from the IRS? How many of you receive joy when you receive a letter from the IRS? Not many. How many of you would prefer not to be contacted by the IRS? Say amen.
Amen.
And that this group was considered the tax collectors in our time of John the Baptist in our time of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. And what's fascinating is that John the Baptist did not tell the tax collectors to go away. John the Baptist did not exclude the tax collectors. John the Baptist was inclusive, even to a group of people who were perceived to do unjust actions. He said, no, 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 there's still something for you to do. Even to a group of people who may have probably made some mistakes, some missteps in their lives. John the Baptist informed them to, you know what, treat people kindly. Do not take more than you ought to take. There's still room for you in God's kingdom. That makes me feel good today on this Sunday, December 12th, 2021. It makes me feel good that all of us, we have a place in God's kingdom. All of us are able to be a participant if we are honest with ourselves. We too have made some mistakes, if we're honest with ourselves. We have not treated everyone justly. If we're honest with ourselves, we've hurt some people's feelings. We've taken advantage of some situations and some individuals in which, if we could, we would have done differently. During this season of Advent, we are reminded that if the tax collectors have a seat at God's table, if the tax collectors are asking the question, what should they do? It is never too late for any of us to ask that same question. So what should you be doing during this season of your life? What should you be doing in response to God's word? What should you be doing in response to God's care? John the Baptist, Jesus' cousin, older cousin, one of the more popular sermons that John the Baptist gave, and many of you probably remember, John the Baptist said during one of his sermons, prepare ye the way. Prepare ye the way of the Lord, of Jesus Christ. And during this season of Advent, we are preparing ourselves, preparing our hearts, preparing our minds, preparing our lives by lighting candles of hope, but also being hope for our families, for our communities, for peoples on our jobs, for strangers we meet, displaying random acts of kindness. John the Baptist, being a powerful preacher, teacher, and leader, other people asked him a question. The crowd, the tax collectors, and also the soldiers. The soldiers being known to falsely accuse people. The soldiers being known to arrest people who were oftentimes innocent. I'm talking about the soldiers who arrested and who chased after Jesus time and time and time again. Although those same soldiers that eventually arrested John the Baptist. Those soldiers asked, what should we do? John the Baptist, not telling the soldiers to leave. John the Baptist not being exclusive. John the Baptist not being accusatory. But John the Baptist constantly seeing windows of opportunity for people to be saved, for people to do better, for people to repent, for people to have another chance and another chance. Oh, I am so glad that we here on this Sunday, December 12th, 2021, the third Sunday of Advent, we have opportunities to do better. We have opportunities to repent. We have opportunities to improve. John the Baptist's response to those soldiers. The response was, do not falsely accuse people. Do not falsely arrest people. Treat people justly. If we're honest with ourselves, you and I are one of the individuals in the midst of that crowd in 2021, still asking questions, how can we do better? What should we do? If we're honest with ourselves, you and I are standing side by side, even with the tax collectors. What should we do? If we're honest with ourselves, we are standing and sitting side by side with everyone in the crowd. So what should we do in 2021? In the midst of tornadoes and people losing things, we ought to share what we have, because a little to some is a lot to others. What should we do in the seasons of Black Lives Matter and in the seasons of just nonsense as it relates to crime? We should treat people fairly. What should we do? In an age where people are being attacked verbally and being attacked online and being attacked on social media, what should we do? As people of faith, we should respectfully acknowledge people's identity and their personhood and love them as if we're loving ourselves. What should we do in 2021 when most people are acting like they're only concerned about them, me, myself, and I? John the Baptist reminds us to prepare ye the way, that there's a Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, whose light reflects hope, love, and mercy and joy. What should we do? We should do something, because what the enemy wants us to do is nothing at all. The enemy wants us to think that we are excluded. The enemy wants us to think that the windows of opportunity have been closed, never to open again. John the Baptist gives us a powerful message today to say, no, 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 you have something to do. Yes, you have something to do. John the Baptist says, yes, you tax collectors, yes, you who are part of the crowd, whatever your demographic you're a part of, whatever your identity, whatever your personhood, yes, God's word applies to you in the most loving and miraculous and graceful ways. A little bit, maybe for others, but to some, it's a lot. Not only receive the light, but be the light. And during this season of Advent, we are so happy that when we reflect on the book of Genesis, the first chapter, the third verse, that the first words that our God, the creator of the universe, spoke was, "Let there be light." And I am glad that we continue to light the candles even to this day in 2021. Do not let your candle of hope go out, no matter what's going on in your journey. Do not let your candle of love go out. Whatever valleys you may be going through, do not let your candle of joy become so dim that you cannot experience it and that others cannot witness it. Trust me, our society needs your light. Our society and world need you to light the candles and be the light forever and always. And the church says, amen. My brothers and sisters,
wherever you are on your journey, wherever the mountains or the valleys may be taking you, you may be asking a variety of questions. What should you be doing? And you may be also asking the question, what is God doing? I want you to know on this day that God is still saving. God is still forgiving. God is still redeeming. And that if you are listening to this message or looking at this message, that means that your window of opportunity is still open. Let us pray. Eternal God, we are thankful for your light of love. We're thankful for your light of grace and mercy. We thank you for your light of hope and joy. Lord, we ask you to allow us to position ourselves to receive all the light that you have for us. And allow us to position ourselves that we will also be the light for others. We include the families and the people of Kentucky that's been impacted by the vicious storms. Lord, we ask you that even in the midst, in the aftermath of tornadoes, we ask you to send your light. Lord, we include the families of Illinois. Even in the aftermath of tornadoes, we ask you, Lord, to send your light. Allow us to facilitate the light in a variety of supportive ways. Lord, your city of Los Angeles in the state of California needs your light. Allow us, Lord, to always remember that divine light exists in you. Lord, the United States of America is in need of your precious, gracious, forgiving, holy light. Allow us to be facilitators of that light in supportive ways. Lord, the entire universe is in need of your light. We are thankful that those words were the first words that you spoke. Allow us to depend upon the light, rely on your light, receive and reflect your light. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. My brothers and sisters, the first announcement I would like to give you is that yesterday we had a wonderful United Methodist men's meeting. We always meet by Zoom because of the COVID-19 pandemic, and I'm glad to say that our president, in the person of Dr. Joseph Gambrell, he wanted me to give you this announcement for all the men and women who's over 70 years old. For those of you who are required to take a required minimum distribution, RMD, he wants to encourage everyone that to remember that if you're qualified to give to a charity, that make sure you include Holman United Methodist Church and designate it for the principal of our mortgage. Our initiative is that Holman United Methodist Church will eventually, by God's grace, become debt-free. And we are launching an initiative to pay off the mortgage by being aggressively paying off the principal. Dr. Gambrell and the United Methodist Men, they are asking everyone to designate a special donation to the paying off the mortgage, and to remember that if you take out your required minimum distribution, that the check must be made by your financial institution to Holman United Methodist Church. God bless you and thank you for your consideration.
Our radio broadcast ministry is in tribute to the Amen Inc. International STEM Center and founders, Professor Hildreth Howe Walker Jr. and Dr. Betty Davis Walker. Dr. Walker conducted this first pilot education research project focusing on science and funded by UCLA in 1986. More than tens of thousands of youth have completed the STEM program and graduated from colleges and universities worldwide. To God be the glory. Our flowers on the altar in grateful celebration of the life of Irene Beverly West Cephas, who would have been 102 years old this day. Your motherly love is still felt daily. You are truly missed by all, especially your family. God holds you in his loving arms, Camille and Tommy Wolfart and family. Pray for the bereaved. Dr. Randy Ross, saxophone player with the Blue Morning Quintet. Other members include Greg Brodus, keyboard, Paul Batson, guitar, Marion Newton, bass, and Ricardo L.J. Mowat, drums and percussions, made his transition. A memorial service will be held at Unity Church in Pasadena on Saturday, December 18th. Holman has been blessed to experience the Blue Morning Quartet and talent of Dr. Randy Ross in past years with performances at the Concert Under the Stars, Hope Coffee House, and Jazz for the Soul. Let us remember in prayer the family of Dr. Randy Ross, Ricardo Mowat, and members of the Blue Morning Quintet, and Reverend Marguerite Phillips. Our general announcements. Sunday school lesson for children is available on the Holman website. Families are encouraged to share the lesson with their children. We also invite you to engage in the weekly Advent activities provided by our Advent Task Force. This Sunday and next Sunday, we are collecting Christmas cards for the four refugee families that are being supported by the CalPAC Disaster Task Force with housing in Victorville by our CalPAC United Methodist Church's Border Ministry. Join us by providing a Christmas card for each of the four families. Cards will be collected at worship today, December 12th, and Sunday, December 19th. Cards are available today for you to sign, or you can mail yours to the church. Please see the article in the December Bell Ringer on this project. Thank you for joining in the opportunity to extend a Christmas welcome as they plant roots in their new home. Holman invites you to join us today, December 12th at 2 p.m., for our virtual installation of our newly elected officers. We give thanks for our sisters who will take the torch as we continue to be faith, love, hope, in action and mission to women, children, and families. Please contact Carolyn Magruder for the Zoom login information. During the season of Advent, it is our tradition at Holman to adorn our sanctuary with beautiful, vivid rows of poinsettias. Because of the COVID-19 pandemic, the sanctuary will not be adorned with as many poinsettias. You may virtually purchase poinsettias in memory or honor of your loved ones. The donations received for the poinsettias will be used to help support the radio broadcast and other church ministries. Donations for each 7-inch plant is $10. Beyond the Battlefield Ministry has launched a prayer line that is available to all. You may call the dedicated prayer line at 323-703-1545. You can request prayer 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. You can hear a recorded prayer and or leave your prayer request and contact information. A prayer partner will get back to you as soon as possible. Holman believes in the power of prayer to change things. We hope that you will find this to be a valuable resource as you navigate life's challenges and celebrate life's blessings. The December session of the Holman Soul Force Nonviolence Workshop, facilitated by Reverend James M. Lawson Jr., will be held on Saturday, December 18th at 9 a.m. via Zoom. Participation in the workshop is free, but registration is required. Lastly, please note that submissions for the December 26th and January 2nd church bulletins are due to Joni R. Lane at HolmanUMC.com no later than this coming Wednesday, December 15th. Please visit the Holman website for additional information and announcements and opportunities to engage in ministry. We thank you for your continued support and partnership in ministry. God bless you.
We are so happy that yesterday there was a wonderful celebration of our pastor emeritus in the form of Reverend James Lawson. Yesterday was the official ceremony of the UCLA James Lawson Jr. Worker for Justice Center dedication. And we are thankful for your prayerful support and celebrating with us for that wonderful, wonderful acknowledgement of our pastor emeritus. Now, today and for generations to come, on UCLA's campus, for every student, alumnus, visitor, and friend, the James Lawson Center for Justice will be recognized and also gathered. It's a wonderful testament about the power of individual and collective light. Continue to open your eyes, continue to open your ears, continue to open your hearts and receive this blessing. May God's light of hope, love, and joy always surround you. May God's angels always provide nurturing lights wherever your journey may lead. And may God's Holy Spirit provide a light to encourage and nurture you all the days of your life. In the name of the Father, Son, Holy Spirit, we pray. Amen.
Wow.
have enjoyed our broadcast today and that it met a spiritual need in your life. If it was helpful, you can support this radio ministry by donating online at holmanchurch.com or by calling the church office at 323-703-5868. Again, that's 323-703-5868 or online at holmanchurch.com. That's H-O-L-M-A-N, holmanchurch.com. Today's YouTube broadcast was sponsored in tribute to the Amen Incorporated International STEM Center and founders, Professor Hal Walker and Dr. Betty Davis Walker. We thank them for their support. Holman Church is located at 3320 West Adams Boulevard. That's Adams Boulevard and 4th Avenue in the historic West Adams District of Los Angeles. We wish God's blessing on you to have a wonderful week, and thank you for sharing this time with the Holman United Methodist Church on radio station KJLH 102.3 FM.
And everywhere on the internet via the Holman Church YouTube channel.
Remember, you can contribute and find out more about us at holmanchurch.com. We hope to hear from you and see you soon.